Hello and welcome to episode 2 of What Agents or Casting Directors May Ask You in an Interview. So we left off with what is your dream role? And I kind of gave you an idea of how to answer that. So the first question of part 2 is, have you ever been repped before? Have you ever had any agents? And for people who have had representation before, you could say, yeah, I've been represented by so-and-so. They are still repping me on a non-exclusive basis. And non-exclusive means you could work with multiple different agencies. And if you haven't ever been repped before, what you say is, I have been freelancing for this amount of time, as long as you've been in the industry, and I have been able to book so-and-so on my own. Even if it's a community theater role and you get $20 at the end of each show, it's still something you booked on your own. So you could say something like, well, I booked community theater. Well, don't say community theater. Say I booked this name of the theater, the musical or theater show you're in, and I worked with da-da-da on my own. And I would love to be able to work with someone who believes in me to get me seen by others and bigger productions. So that's something you could say if you feel like you've never had representation, you don't know where you are going to go with that question. You could say something along the lines of what you've been in before. Community theater, you don't have to word it as community theater. It's still like you were a certain role in a theatrical production. That's all they care about. I know a lot of people who haven't really ever did anything besides community theater already get up to certain Broadway auditions because of their talent. And at times, sometimes people without certain representation don't get certain opportunities. So that's something you could base your expertise off of. What you already booked on your own, what roles, how versatile the roles you could play are. It is definitely something you could do in order to get yourself repped by that agency. And here's another question they're going to ask in case they forgot how they contacted you in the first place. How did we get connected? How did you find us? So sometimes an agent's gonna contact you on Actors Access, Casting Networks, and other times around, you're gonna submit yourself on their website, and if they're interested in seeing you, they're gonna message you. So you could say, well, Stacy Jean messaged me on Casting Networks saying that she would love to represent me, and that's why I contact your office to set up an appointment. Otherwise, you could say, I submitted and I got an email saying you were interested in meeting me, so here I am. It doesn't have to be a super long answer, as long as you let them know where the heck you came from. They'll probably remember, but sometimes some agencies have so many people on their roster, so many people to keep track of that they might forget, but they'll remember. And this question, I feel like I even hate because my birthday's coming up and I'm just like, oh my god, another year older. But they're gonna ask, how old are you? What age range can you play? And I was told for this one, just to be honest, because I'm the type of person, if I could be younger, I'll be as young as you want me to be. But it's very important to say your actual age. It just shows you're honest to begin with, because before I got certain feedback, I would go into certain offices saying, well, how old do you think I am? And then when an agent would guess, I'd be like, oh, 21, you got that right. Even though that's not the way to do it, but I used to do that because I felt like you had to be like a certain age. But you don't. As long as you take care of yourself and you look good, you look younger, you can play younger, you got it. and the age range. It could be in whatever last films you were in, how you see yourself. A lot of times certain people, even in their 30s, can't play 25 yet because they haven't aged, they have baby faces. So it all depends on the roles you've gotten, independent films, community theater, or if you're professional, like what big shows have you been in and what was the age range of that character, or what age. That's where you would answer and get a clearer perspective of where you would fit in on their roster for that question. And this is another question that people might get asked, especially since this world is so into doing self-tapes right now. It's a lot harder to really get those in-person auditions. I feel like it's starting to come back, but I feel like self-taping is never really going to go away, which isn't necessarily a bad thing because you are able to audition for multiple cities, multiple countries in the same room without traveling. So that's going to save a lot of money on airfare. So that's a benefit. But sometimes you're going to have to work with professionals, and you're going to have to sometimes invest a little bit in making sure your audition is perfect. If an agent's going to get you a really, really big audition, like a main character role next to Ryan Gosling or a big name actor, you might have to invest a little bit of money and work with a professional in order to make sure your audition tape is perfect. There's not going to be any light issues, sound issues. Most of the time, I would say you could do your self-tapes at home as long as you know what you're doing. As long as you have a reader on Zoom or in person, a sibling who can read with you, that's fine. But sometimes you're going to have to invest, and they care about who you work with. And if you're willing to invest, that's a question that they want answered also. They want to make sure that you're not just going to stand in front of a white wall if they're getting you like Marvel auditions. They want to make sure at least you have a backdrop, you have a setup, you have lights, you're editing your sound. Cool. So they just want to make sure that they look good with your name on their auditions. And this one is really, this throws off a lot of people, especially when they are in a job interview. What are your special skills? And I feel like this could be something related to the industry and also not so related. So what I do for mine is I used to do princess parties. So I put, I am a character performer. I used to do birthday parties for toddlers, children, and I'm also a promotional model. I represent a lot of liquor brands. I do trade shows. I'm a trade show model. And I also love to do nature photography. I love to dance. And it's just making sure you're a human too. Well, I mean, they know you're a human, but it's just making sure your life isn't all about acting. Sometimes agents love to see that you have a business degree or you went to law school. For this next question, it gets a lot of mixed reviews because a lot of people have mixed reviews about joining the union. So your agent's going to ask you, what's your union status and are you willing to join a union? And in order to keep that as positive as possible, you could say, yes, I'm part of the union. I only do union work. Or if you're non-union, even if you don't want to necessarily join, you say, currently I'm non-union, but if the opportunity arises, I would love to discuss that opportunity further. Always just keep it positive, even if you don't necessarily want to be in the union. I know a lot of commercial work is non-union, but it's definitely something that you want to keep positive when talking to an agent about. And the last but not least question is, what do you expect from an agent or manager? And this is where you could have all your criteria. Do you expect to get like one check-in a week? Would you like to have consistent communication with your agent? It's your time to interview your possible agent. Because I feel like too many people go into agent interviews thinking that if they don't get this agent, that it's going to be the end for them. That's very far from the truth because there's so many agents that one of them is going to love you. You're going to find that perfect fit. Sometimes it takes a lot of no's on both ends in order to find that perfect fit for you. And my encouragement is to not give up, that there is someone out there. And if something doesn't feel right to you about a possible agent, go with your gut. You don't want to be in an exclusive contract for a year with an agent that doesn't do anything for you and you have a hard time breaking out of that. Be sure that you're able to feel like you have a mutual understanding of one another and that you're able to express your concerns and you'll get a response and that your agent's going to be nice if you have a question. Because I've had, like, my first agent I ever had, I jumped right in, went into an exclusive contract, and for that whole year, I didn't get a single audition at all. I was like, what's going on here? And then I was sent to a really weird photographer, and when I spent a few hundred on those headshots, it was pretty much like outside by a lake. I mean, they weren't terrible pictures, but they weren't really headshots. That put me into a worse place. Like, I was more in, like, loss of money, and I didn't get to where I wanted to be. So it's really, really important that you follow your gut no matter what. Like, even if you feel like something's off and you don't want to give a yes or no, you could say, well, I'm going to look over this contract and I'll get back to you. And if they don't like that, that's fine. You don't have to be pressured to sign to be exclusive right on the spot either. Or non-exclusive, because still, you can still book a lot of work on your own. And if they book that for you or help you, they get 10, 20%. So that's your finances. And you have every single right to question a contract, to think about if you want to sign or not sign. And of course, say no, or even revise your contract. And I'll be doing another video talking about how you could possibly negotiate, and that's a whole different topic. But I just wanted to end this with, you guys are powerful human beings. As actors, I feel like we make ourselves a lot smaller just so we could be picked, but a lot of times that just makes us blend in. And if you want to stand out, have your boundaries. Have every single thing you want from an agent up and ready to be reviewed. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching this video. And if you guys have any questions, feel free to message me privately, or if you'd like to leave some questions in the comments. But I'd like to thank you guys so much for watching my videos and